Antarctica is a vast icy wasteland, covered by the world's largest ice sheet. This ice sheet contains about 90% of fresh water on the planet. It acts as a massive heat sink, and its meltwater drives the world's oceanic circulation. Its existence is therefore a fundamental part of Earth's climate. A less known fact is that Antarctica is also host to several active volcanoes, part of a huge volcano province that extends for thousands of miles along the continent's western edge. Although the volcanic province has been known and studied for decades, about 100 new volcanoes were recently discovered beneath the ice by scientists who use satellite data and ice-penetrating radar to search for hidden peaks. These sub-ice volcanoes may be dormant, but what would happen if these hidden volcanoes erupted? Mount Taka, found in the West Antarctic Ice Sheet's remote center, has erupted many times in the past. In a new study, scientists implicate Taka in a series of eruptions rich in ozone-consuming halogens that occurred about 18,000 years ago. These eruptions might be the reason for triggering an ancient ozone hole, warming the southern hemisphere, which caused glaciers to melt and helped bring the last ice age to a close. This sort of environmental impact is unusual. For it to happen again would require a series of eruptions, similar enriched in halogens, from one or more volcanoes that are currently exposed above the ice. Such a scenario is pretty unlikely. It's more likely is that one or more of the many subglacial volcanoes, some of which are known to be active, will erupt at some unknown time in the far future. Because of the enormous thickness of overlying ice, it is unlikely that volcanic gases would make it into the atmosphere, so the eruption wouldn't be as impactful as other volcanoes. However, the volcanoes would melt huge caverns in the base of the ice and create enormous quantities of meltwater. Because the West Antarctic ice sheet is wet rather than frozen to its bed, imagine an ice cube on a kitchen worktop. The meltwater would act as a lubricant and could cause the overlying ice to slip and move more rapidly. These volcanoes could also stabilize the ice. However, as they give it something to grip onto, imagine that same ice cube snagging onto a lump-shaped object. In any case, the volume of water that would be generated by even a large volcano is a pinprick compared to the volume of overlying ice. So a single eruption won't really have much effect on the ice flow. What would make a big difference is if several volcanoes erupt close to or beneath any of West Antarctica's prominent ice streams. Now, ice streams, they are rivers of ice that flow much faster than their surroundings. They are zones along which most of the ice in Antarctica is delivered to the ocean, and therefore fluctuations in their speed can affect the sea level. If the additional lubricant provided by multiple volcanic eruptions was channeled beneath ice streams, the subsequent rapid flow may dump unusual amounts of West Antarctica's thick interior ice into the ocean, causing those pesky sea levels to keep rising. Under ice, volcanoes are probably what triggered a rapid flow of ancient ice streams into the vast Ross Ice Shelf, Antarctica's largest ice shelf. Something similar might have occurred about 2,000 years ago with a small volcano in the Hudson Mountains that lie underneath the West Antarctic ice sheet. If it erupted again today, it could cause the nearby Pine Island Glacier to speed up. Most dramatic of all, a large series of eruptions could destabilize many more subglacial volcanoes. As volcanoes cool and crystallize, their magma chambers become pressurized, and all that prevents the volcanic gases from escaping violently in an eruption is the weight of the overlying rock, or in this case, several miles in ice. As that ice becomes much thinner, the pressure reduction may trigger eruptions. More eruptions and ice melting would mean even more meltwater being channeled under the ice streams. Potentially, a runaway effect may take place, with the thinning ice triggering more and more eruptions. Something similar actually occurred in Iceland, which saw an increase in volcanic eruptions when glaciers began to recede at the end of the last ice age. So it seems the greatest threat from Antarctica's many volcanoes will be if several erupt within a few decades of each other, If those volcanoes have already grown above the ice and their gases were rich in halogens, then enhanced warming and rapid deglaciation may result. But eruptions probably need to take place repeatedly over many tens to hundreds of years to actually have an impact on the climate. More likely is the generation of large quantities of meltwater during subglacial eruptions that might lubricate West Antarctica's ice streams. The eruption of even a single volcano situated strategically close to any of Antarctica's ice streams can cause significant amounts of ice to be swept into the sea. However, the resulting thinning of the inland ice is also likely to trigger further subglacial eruptions, generating meltwater over a wider area and potentially causing a runaway effect on ice flow. This might seem terrifying, but the probability of the eruption in Antarctica is very slim. Still, there are some possibilities for these volcanoes to erupt, but the time frame would be in 100,000 to a million years. So you don't really even need to worry about this within your lifetime. But the thing in which you would need to care about is what would happen if all the ice in Antarctica melts? Well, actually, you know, that sounds like a different video to speculate and investigate here on Discover Zen.